Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Colin Harrington. He's the Chief Executive of Zephyr Energy. Colin, very good to speak with you again.
Good to see you, Stephen. How are you?
I'm good, thank you, Colin. Colin, you're up with fourth quarter production results. Can you give us a broad overview of the quarter?
Sure, happy to. Another strong quarter from the non-op business. We're just really, really happy with how this portfolio has been performing. So average production across the quarter was up 7%. But we were peaking much higher as the quarter went through because we had our new Slawson wells that didn't start, cleaning up and producing until late November, and then were temporarily curtailed in December. So we didn't get the uptime availability we thought from that, but we did get great performance when they were on. So production looked strong. Revenues as well were up across the quarter. And, you know, this was in a period of much softer oil prices, and again, accounted for the loss and lack of availability. So all in all, a really strong quarter, and we're also seeing great results, results so far this first quarter.
Colin, bad weather in Williston drew a lot of attention over the winter. How did that impact production?
Yeah, and that was incredible. I mean, at one point, over half the basin was shut in due to extreme cold temperatures. For most of the portfolio, there was no impact. We really didn't get impacted around our Sanish assets the way that some other operators did. Again, on the Slawson side, we did see temporary curtailments there because of the impact on both infrastructure and on the wells themselves. But they are now back up online and producing as we expected them to produce. So I feel like we've gotten through the worst of it, and luckily overall availability wasn't impacted greatly.
Well, subsequent to the quarter, new wells have come online in the first quarter. How are they performing?
Yeah, so that's been great to see. These are the Harms and Quarles wells. And what's been really nice is that, you know, we only have small interests here, so it wasn't much CapEx going in, but the performance has been great. So we're getting, you know, average about 75 BOE a day from those wells, and also in addition to the continued growth from Slawson. So first quarter should be a great quarter for us.
Colin, you've amended how you'll report quarterly numbers going forward. What's behind that change?
Yeah, and this is interesting. I mean, when we had a much smaller portfolio and exposure to fewer operators, it was easier to get sales volume data. Sales volume is three-phase data. So it's oil, gas, and NGLs. There's always a lag to get that data. But as we've grown and we have over 225 wells and we've got many more operators, some of them give us timely information, and some of them there can be up to a two-month lag. So in an effort to keep our production, our reporting both uniform and timely and consistent, we're going to move to reporting only two-phase data. So that is oil and gas production for a given quarter. And then on an annual basis, we'll break that out into the three-phase volumes and be able to give more granular sales data at that point.
Colin, what's next for Zephyr?
Well, I think what everybody's focused on, certainly what we're focused on, is the upcoming drill in the Paradox. This is the 36-2R, the redrill of the 36-2. We went through an incredibly intensive planning process over the winter to get ready for this. That was both our internal team and bringing in a lot of high-powered consultants that work for high-pressure, high-temperature work in those areas, and were able to give us a lot of input. So very happy with how the well plan turned out. We submitted our permits. We just received those. And now we're turning to finalizing the rig contract selecting side. That has been an interesting one. The availability is much better this time than it was last year. And we're certainly doing a pretty intensive look there too. You're comparing specs, schedule, cost, timing, all of that. We're very close to being able to put out more on that. And we hope to be drilling in the very near term. So lots happening there. There's groundwork going on. We've been berming up some of the water tanks that are there on site and just preparing so that we can go as quickly as possible. Really happy with how this part of the process has unfolded, and can't wait to get the drill bit in the ground and turning.
I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress. Thank you very much for the update today.
Absolutely. Thank you, Stephen. And thanks for everyone for watching.
That's Colin Harrington. He's Chief Executive of Zephyr Energy.